Wait, I just realized it's Mario's 35th anniversary this year. I should do a Mario video, huh? But no rush, I imagine. How many days do I have left? Oh, crap, I need to do one now. You'll work. Let's do this. This is Brand New Relic, the monthly series where I finally play the classic games I never got to try. First off, I'd say there's spoilers for Super Mario Galaxy 2, but, I mean, doesn't everyone know by now how a Mario game goes down? Yes, Mario turned 35 this year. As long as you don't count, you know, Donkey Kong, Donkey Kong Jr., Mario Brothers, tennis, pinball, golf, all these Game & Watch games. But to be fair, all those times he wasn't Super. Now he's Super. And you'll be surprised to know that I haven't played... Oh wait, no, played that. And that. Yeah. Yeah, okay. That too. Yeah. Oh, even the mobile version. Yeah, okay. Alright, well, it turns out for being a Sega kid, I played a lot of Mario. But there are still a few out there that I haven't played, and thanks to the newly released Super Mario 3D All-Stars, I can finally play that timeless classic... Wait, where's Galaxy 2? Come on, Nintendo, what gives? It's not like you gave yourself the unenviable task of remastering several large video games into one package only to find yourselves in the midst of a global pandemic and suddenly facing a tight deadline of needing to get the game out before an important anniversary came to an end. Get it together! So I'm busting out the Wii and getting my wrists ready for some major flicking.
Here we go!
My guess is I already know quite a bit about this one, partly because, you know, it's a Mario game, so I'm pretty sure Bowser's gonna kidnap Princess Peach. Just, you know, just a hunch. But also because I played through Super Mario Galaxy 1, which... Whew. We're all friends, right? I'm gonna be honest with you. I wasn't the biggest fan of- I know, okay? I know. It's not like I hated it, I just didn't think it was the best Mario game of all time. Oh my god, okay. Can I finish? Can I finish? Galaxy has perhaps the greatest aesthetic of any Mario game, both visually and musically, but the margin for error was so low that it became more frustrating than rewarding for me. As I was getting to the end of the game, trying to finish it kind of felt like a chore, and not a fun chore like crushing soda cans. I'm down for a good challenge. I love Super Meat Boy and Cuphead and a lot of the difficult Mario Maker levels that I played, but where titles like Super Mario Bros. 3 felt like a nice balance between challenge and reward, Galaxy felt more like, say, the Lost levels. When I got to the end, I didn't feel triumph. I felt relief that it was done. But that's Galaxy 1, and we're talking Galaxy 2. So let's see if the sequel can change my mind about this particular sub-franchise.
Super Mario Galaxy! Woohoo!
Mario is never more excited than when he sang the title of his own game. And hey, check me out, I look great as a planet. I get this lovely storybook opening as Mario meets this guy who curses at us using PlayStation symbols. And then I run into Bowser, who's clearly been taking performance-enhancing drugs, and he wants us to guess what else he has. Oh, I don't know, could it be... Yep, there it is. You know what, maybe I don't save her this time. Seriously, what if I just flew around the galaxy and got into adventures because I wanted some me time? To really get to know the Mario that stares back in the mirror. But like an Aaron Sorkin character obsessed with Gilbert and Sullivan, I'm beholden to duty. And yes, I said it. Duty. So our new friend hides in my cap like it's Ratatouille, and I don't remember this part of the movie Gravity. I go through this tutorial stage in which I kill a baby before it really got a chance to live. Off to a noble start. And cool, I got a star! Game's done! But no, I take off in this spaceship with Lubba and the Loomas, who I think I saw open for the Killers at the Greek Theater. And no, don't make this spaceship look like Mario, he already has a big head, don't make that literal. And my choices are That's Right and Yes. Whoa, slow down there, Telltale! While I miss Rosalina from Galaxy, I'm 100% here for Lubba's puns. So I fly off to my first galaxy and, aw, hello, old friend, and... Okay, that's on me, but it still doesn't bode well. Also, how do they breathe in space? I get my first power-up.
Drill, baby, drill!
And it gets stored in our face ship. Turns out there's so much more to this ship than I previously thought, including an ear piercing. I can unlock other galaxies by indulging this Luma's gluttony, and hold on, that's a star, right? But it eats star bits? Anyway, doing so unlocks a more challenging galaxy, and I cannot believe I somehow finished this stage in one try. Maybe I'm good at this after all. Okay, you know, whatever. So then I get my second power-up, which allows Mario to make clouds, which could really help out the local agriculture, but nope, he's just using it for platforming. So then I meet this totally radical chimp, and I just realized how much I love Mario's dismount every time he lands in a new galaxy.
Yes!
I meet Gobblegut, who does terrible things to this planet's infrastructure, and then I'm on to the next solar system. I reunite with Yoshi, who... Oh, wow, bye, sorry. Then I'm at Twin Falls. What is this, the 8th largest city in Idaho? And you're bored of platforming, you say? Well, don't worry, because almost every galaxy throws a new way of playing at you. In a short amount of time, Mario's tumbling, then he's swimming, then he's gliding, then he's... buzzing? And all of them are actually pretty fun to play. And then I'm in a different aspect ratio, because OBS just decided that it wanted to do that, apparently. And these tutorials actually make the game a little more manageable. Although I do keep biting it on these floor chompers. I fight Bowser for the first time and... oh, hey, Mario. So wait, Bowser was only huge because he ate a grand star? Eat the grand star, Mario, eat it! And then Yoshi lets off a little steam. Nah, it's okay, I'll see myself out. I try the mother of all slides and I run into Luigi. And then I become Luigi, and my aspect ratio is back to normal and right on time because I finally get the Fire Flower. This will make going through the game so much easier now that I... oh, it's temporary. Alright. But at least I'm not sliding around like in 99% of other winter levels, and then...
they see me rolling.
Then I move forward to... oh, I don't have enough stars. So then I move back and replay certain worlds to get more stars, and it turns out that there are prankster comets that make the game just that much more difficult, which is exactly what I wanted. But I somehow managed to complete the challenge, which was the totally radical chimp asking me to... commit mass murder. For points. What a couple of cool guys. But he compliments my mustache, so that's cool. And I start getting to the point in the game that requires precision, which is not easy with these controls. Once again, I become a rolling stone. I have a fun rhythm-based level, I fly to the next solar system, and why does my face ship sound like a freight train? On the face ship, there's a guy called Bank Toad who holds onto my star bits for me, which is very considerate. Heyo. Then after stomping on some bellies, Lubba tells me to have fun with my unusual toy.
Okay.
And then, oh no. We have lava, which is absolutely the worst. There are no invincibility frames, which means this happens a lot. And if you do manage to land on a not lava surface, this happens. But at least I don't have to deal with the spring from the first- oh, come on! I hated this thing in Galaxy 1, and I hate it now. Paired with the lava, and it's just the worst. I die on this level a lot, and there's nothing that will make me feel better about- okay, that does actually make me feel better. Thank you, Lubba. And then I'm hanging out with these characters who I know are from Super Mario Sunshine, but I don't know what they're called. Piantas. I'll allow it. Then I'm in another Bowser castle where I fret a stare up the walls, and yeah, I really hate the lava.
I'm using the word hate here.
And once again, I find myself needing to go back and replay worlds in order to get enough stars. You remember in Super Mario Bros. 3 when you had to grind other worlds in order to move forward? Yeah, me neither. Yes, I know it's a thing in all of the 3D Mario games, I know, it doesn't mean I have to like it. Especially when it seems like there aren't that many stars available. So I do some more gliding, and apparently I'm leader of the birds now?
The live crows on set welcomed me as their own. One even tried to mate.
And do all these newly created planets affect, you know, the tide? And no, Banktoad, glasses don't make you good at math, trust me. Seriously. Trust me. And then I'm in a pop-up graveyard, which I'm pretty sure is the thing in Brooklyn. Then I become a ghost, so... wait, is Mario dead? I mean, Mario's died a bunch already, but is he, like, dead? We slow down time, so first Braid ripped off Mario, and now Mario rips off Braid. And then after taking on Mecha Bowser Jr., we're on to the last world, which... wait. I understand that all Mario games are divided into worlds, but each planet is a galaxy, and each collection of planets is called a world. Does this game not know how astronomy works? Anyway, there's more lava, and I hate it all. Especially when paired with ice. I return to Banktoad, and... heyo. And I may not be great at this game, but I had a wonderful time in this clock-themed level. And then I spend 30 minutes on just this one section before landing in... wait, I know this level! Wow, they're rebooting everything, aren't they? And I just realized how sad Mario sounds when he's at one life. And once again, I have to backtrack and find some secret stars in order to be able to progress, but I've come to realize that Luigi could easily get a job with Disney on Ice. So it turns out 70 stars is the amount I need to get to the end, so how do I get there? This chimp challenge ain't it. Neither is this box challenge, so... No, you know what? I'm making this one happen. Nice! And this looks more challenging than it actually is. Dark World gets me to 70 stars! But there's still one galaxy we haven't explored, so why not go for 71? And it ends in this gorgeous place. Which is nice for Luigi, since we won't be using him for the rest of the game. Enjoy the view, Luigi. You've earned it. So now it's time to face off with Bowser one last time. But first, there's a whole level that I have to get through, so let's see. But eventually I get there and I'm able to take him down, except... This is a fake out, right? This is definitely a fake out. Yep, there we go. But we defeat him for real, Princess Peach is back, and oh hey, Rosalina. Better late than never, right? Our companion leaves with her while we're stuck with this guy. But I can't stay mad about that, Lubba, you're the best. And then we get to play through the end credits. Hey look, I'm Sisyphus. And then we're told that there's a secret world? Yeah. Yeah, no thanks. There's so much here that's amazing. Much like Galaxy 1, this is a gorgeous game, both in its looks and sounds. Almost every time the beginning of a level did that cinematic sweep across the landscape, I would say, ooh! And not just because I was eating pumpkin cheesecake at the time, though I was definitely eating pumpkin cheesecake at the time. Also, by the way, I learned how to make pumpkin cheesecake. It's because the worlds, oh, sorry, the galaxies, this game really needs a dictionary, are so beautifully thought out, constantly surprising me with their unique and varied designs. Unlike some of the older Mario games, I never felt like I was just replaying a previous level. Except for the times I was literally replaying a previous level. And many of these galaxies were a downright joy to go through. I'd get excited every time I'd see a right-side-down section or a tile switch area. It helped that there were tutorials spread out around the game that would help you figure out the right mechanics for progression. And the home base of the face ship was also a delight. Every time you met a new character or got a new power-up, it found its way onto your ship, along with opportunities for one-ups. It was a lot easier to navigate than the hub in Galaxy 1 and provided its own opportunities for exploration. And unlike other 3D Mario games, including Odyssey, I didn't hate many of the mechanics that I normally despise in Mario games. Like swimming, gliding, rolling, or sliding. That section that I mentioned spending 30 minutes on? Yeah, I died a lot, but I didn't mind, as I was having a good time making incremental progress. But then... Again, I understand that this is a staple of 3D Mario games, but requiring precision with imprecise controls just doesn't strike me as fun. Having an enemy or obstacle knock me off a ledge, resulting in an instant death, is not fun. The lava is not fun. That stupid spring is not fun. Combining lava and precise controls and that stupid spring is really not fun. Presenting secret stars is optional, but then making me collect them in order to get the required 70 stars is... Well, it's not fun. There was a moment early on when Mario grabbed the ledge before falling, and I got a little bit of hope. Was this game going to attempt more of a balance? Nah. I breathed a sigh of relief every time I switched to a 2D perspective, because at least that felt fair. But asking for perfect movement using the nunchuck? The nunchuck? Ultimately, it came down to the same question I asked myself with Galaxy 1. Was it fun to get to the ending? With Odyssey or World or even 3D Land, the answer was a resounding yes. With Galaxy 1, it was a big no. Here, it was a kinda. The fact that I gathered 70 stars and still decided to play one more galaxy is a good sign. But when that secret world opened up, I had zero desire to check it out. Besides, how many more stars can I even collect in this thing? Like 20 or 30 or 242 stars? There are still- Hold on, I need to do the math. I haven't been sleeping much lately because of the baby, and glasses really don't make you good at math, Bangtoad. 172 more stars to collect! Knowing that the challenges will only get worse, that the game will only get harder, that doesn't make me want to go back. It makes me want to move on. Also, it's been said before, but I'm saying it now. Princess Peach getting kidnapped is a tired device. There are 50 million reasons for Mario to defeat Bowser other than simply saving the damsel in distress. Mario's an altruist, he's proven that he's willing to help those in trouble, so Bowser's theft of Power Stars is more than enough motivation. But that would require the game to have a bit more story, which isn't out of the question. My favorite part of Galaxy 1 was listening to Rosalina's sad, beautiful story, and it made me more invested in the mission. Here, it's just more of the same. So with all that... If anyone tells me that they love Super Mario Galaxy 2, I can sincerely tell them that I fully understand why. And if anyone tells me that they hate Super Mario Galaxy 2, I can sincerely tell them that I fully understand why. I land somewhere in between. The Galaxy games are nowhere near my favorite entries in the Super Mario series, but there's still a lot to love here, and I'm happy that I gave them a try, though I'm happier to be able to check them off my list. But as this weird, depressing oven fire of a year comes to a close, I can't think of a better way to end it than with a fun platformer. Good riddance, 2020. Let's hope the next year treats us all a little better. And I hope Mario enjoys being 35. Trust me, buddy, it's all downhill from here. I'd like to thank my supporters on Patreon, particularly Brianne Shaw and Haley's mom, and everyone who donated in the Palm Tree Panic tier and above, all of whom got to see this video a whole 3 days early. If you'd like early access, shoutouts, bonus content, and access to polls that help decide future episodes, then go to the internet and type https://www.patreon.com/JeremyGable. You can also follow me on Twitter for further updates and, you know, memes. A new year means 12 more episodes of playing through classic games. Do you have any suggestions? Let me know and it may end up in a future episode. And hey, why don't you like this video and subscribe to this channel and, I don't know, hit the notification bell. We'll beat this algorithm one way or another. My next episode looks at a classic entry in a franchise that spans movies, television, comics, novels, and of course, video games. So until then, thank you so much for watching.